The views and comments expressed on the following radio program by its hosts and their guests do not necessarily reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com or its affiliates. Listener discretion is advised.
Live from RMC Studios in Los Angeles, California, on the Punch It Radio Network. I want to give a quick shout out and an early shout out to our executive producer, Larry Witherspoon, and our lovely sound engineer, Miss Kiki. Happy New Year, Stephanie. How are you?
I'm good. I am so excited about this year. It's not even funny.
I know. Are you ready to voujade?
Oh, yes. I've been voujadeing for like a week already.
So we have a very exciting show today. You know, new year, new outlook on possibilities, what we can do for the future, and really sort of, you know, kickstart, I think, our year. So Heart for the Community, back in 2013, doing a little bit different. So this year, we're going to mix it up a little bit, and we actually have some live music. And so here today to help us kick off Heart for the Community is the lovely Bernice.
Hi.
So she's going to be playing some original and maybe some covers during our breaks today. So you guys get a break from my music selection. So we have today on the phone Simon T. Bailey, who I'm embarrassed to say I didn't know about him until Stephanie, you told me about him. And then I started to sort of do a mad YouTube search on anything that I could find about him. And I think I spent like one Saturday just YouTubing and watching all his videos. And they're educational, they're motivational, but they're funny. He's funny.
He's sharp and witty, and it's just so encouraging. You just like, you go to one video and then you're like,
I know, I want more, more and more.
It is like a drug, Simon's videos.
But we're not in any way connecting him to that kind of a thing.
Oh, absolutely not.
It's like an adrenaline high. Like, we need more. I think he's on the line now, so I'm so excited. So I'm going to let you introduce him, Stephanie, since you know him.
Well, I met Simon at a conference, the Bob Harrison Increase Conference, and he went up on stage, and I was like, who's this dude? And he, as soon as he opened his mouth, I was like, I am home. And it was so funny because he didn't speak at first. Mm-hmm. And my husband and I were sitting in the very, very back row. And Simon and his wife were sitting behind us. And I was like, oh, we're new. We're all new. This guy and his wife and me and my husband. So we turned around and started talking. And lo and behold, he's like one of the keynote speakers. And I was like, I'm not worthy.
You're like, ooh.
And it was the most real conversation. It was authentic. And from that moment on, not knowing who Simon was, and to have a face-to-face with he and his wife,
uh-huh,
and the purity of just casual conversation and it be so intense just mm-hmm. like that, I was like, I'm sold. So when he went up there to speak, I was like, that was the dude that was sitting right behind
us. Isn't that?
Yeah, and so, Simon, welcome.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
So give us, because you can only do it as well as you do it, give us a little bit of background. Tell our listeners a little snippet of your background and what you're doing now. We will jump into the Vujia Day movement in just a moment, but give sure. us a little a snippet of who Simon is.
Oh, my goodness. So mom and dad dropped me off at college a few years back. They call after my first year in college and said, we don't have the money to send you back to college, nor do we have money to bring you back home to Buffalo, but we do love you. And and trust me, I was not feeling the love. So I dropped out of school, moved into a drug-infested community in the southwest part of Atlanta, Georgia, though I was not on drugs. It's all I could afford, on public transportation, and probably really at the lowest point of my life. Eventually did go back to school, got my undergrad degree. I was just on the 10-year plan, if you know what I mean. And then through a series of jobs, about 20 years ago, a young lady saw me at a single soiree and just had to have me. So I decided to marry her and put her out of her misery.
Don't ever tell her that I'm sharing. She's a smart woman.
This is just between us, my new BFF. So,
and all the internet radio listeners.
Yeah, do not share this with her.
That's awesome.
And then professionally, I've worked for 6 different companies, 10 different jobs over the last 25 years. My last job was at Disney, was a leader for Disney Institute, and decided 10 years ago to cash in my entire 401k, take out a line of credit on the house, and throw caution to the wind and went for it. Mm-hmm. And my wife said, I'm with you, we'll figure it out. Mm-hmm. And here we are 10 years later, and working, we've touched almost 1,000 organizations, 1 million people on 6 continents in 10 years, and 7 books, and it's just, I'm having fun.
You should.
Yeah, I know. But I think that's, you know, one of the keys in what you do is if you're enjoying what you do, you have passion for it, you love it, it's not really work anymore.
No.
You know, it's very... It sort of self-generates the positive energy mm-hmm. when you really have a passion for what it is you're doing. Wow. So I was stuck on YouTube for an entire day watching all your YouTube videos. And I was actually on Skype with a friend, and they could hear the audio play, and they were busting up on the other side. They're like, what are you listening to? Who is that? I said, ooh, he's going to be on our show.
Oh,
so he started to YouTube you as well.
Uh-huh.
And he's like, this is amazing. This guy is amazing. He's so I'm motivated. I don't even know what I'm motivated for, but I'm ready.
That's funny.
That's great.
So tell us a little bit about the Vujia Day moment. I know that some of our listeners are probably not familiar with it. I bet a large handful of us are. But for those who are unfamiliar, tell them about what that moment is and what it's all about.
Yeah, so Vujia Day is realizing that life doesn't happen when the alarm goes off. Life happens when you wake up. And when you wake up, it becomes that moment when you decide to flip the script, unleash the inner salmon to swim upstream, and it's that moment when you say, you know what, this doesn't work for me anymore, and doggone it, I've got to bust a move. I got to mm-hmm. do something else. This mm-hmm. is not happening, and if I'm going to get on with my life, because, you know, this is the only life we have, we don't get a do-over, I've got to disrupt and flip the script. I've got to do things differently. That's the Vujia Day moment. So if deja vu means you've already seen it, Vujia Day means I've never seen it, but I know it's out there, and I'm going after something.
Mm-hmm. You know, and one of the, you know, we're starting 2013, and a lot of people have, you know, resolutions or new hope for this new year. And I, you know, I'm so glad that you're here, because I think that your book is all about that, to kind of kickstart, you know, all of us on our journey on what is possible. And we have to be able to flip that switch mm-hmm. in our mind.
Mm-hmm.
And your other book, and I'll let you plug that as well, you know, you talked about you had to get your, you know, that your mind, that ghetto mind in a different position, in a different, I can't even think about what I'm saying. I'm so excited about having you here. But, you know, just that whole mind shift, and being to transition yourself. And for someone who is really sort of stuck and deep-rooted in that kind of dark place, how do you take that first step?
Yeah. So it starts with what I would call a series of questions. The first question that we have to start with is, where have I been? You know, that's just really looking over your life for however long you've been here. Question number two is, why am I here? And that question in and of itself is so important. Because the greatest tragedy in life is not death. The greatest tragedy in life is to be alive and not know why.
Mm-hmm.
And you have a number of people that wake up every single day. The lights are on, but nobody's at home.
Mm-hmm.
So that why am I here question really kind of starts you on the path to saying, okay, what is this really about? And then the third question is, so what can I do? And that taps into your talent, your gifting, your potential, those things that come easy to you, right? And then that fourth question is, where am I going? So the backstory behind the fourth question is, people plan their vacation sometimes better than they plan their lives.
No, that's true.
That's true. You know?
So really, those four questions are what I would say, those clarity questions that really help you come to a moment of raw honesty to say, what is this really all about?
Mm-hmm. That's great. And I think we're going to take a quick break and then kind of dive down deeper. So we'll be right back with okay. Simon T. Bailey on about the Vuja Day moment.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pit Bull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale, lemon lime flavor, Pit Bull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pit Bull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
Everyone to Heart for the Community. We have Bernice in studio with us. And why don't you tell us about that song, the name of it?
It's called Daisies and Hope, and it's kind of a story about falling in love with somebody, and then it turns into, like, cheating and stuff. So it's kind of happy, and then it goes to sad.
That was just a happy part, the first part, right?
Yeah, it was. I love that song, though.
I was like, I'm really happy.
Yeah, it's like in the beginning of a relationship, it's happy, but then it turns into some sad stuff. You got to hear the whole song. Hopefully one day I can play it for you guys.
Absolutely, absolutely.
That was great.
So we are doing something different in 2013. We're having live in-studio musicians come in because they are part of the community.
That's right.
And we have a heart for music and promoting people in the community and about their passion. So we are back with Heart for the Community on heartforradio.com, broadcasting from RMC Studios in Los Angeles, California, on the Punch It Radio Network. I'm having some headset issues, so I'm holding it with my hand, so maybe next break I'll fix it. Quick shout out to our executive producer, Larry Witherspoon, and our sound engineer, Miss Kiki. And also, we have our sponsor for today. So this show is actually being sponsored by the Palmdale Express West Rail Summit. They will be having a free seminar to talk about jobs and opportunities on January 28th, 2013 at the Palmdale Cultural Center from 8 to 5. Admission is free. And if you would like more information, you can contact Stanley Washington at area code 702-581-2687. So we are back with Simon T. Bailey talking about the Vuja Day moment. And I'm going to let Stephanie ask a question.
So, Simon, when you were talking about those four questions and you were saying, like, why am I here? Like, it gave me just this somber feeling in my belly. So many people are in this spot right now where they have had a really rough, tumultuous 2012, almost sorrowful because of so many things, loss of jobs, loss of home, finances, jobs, everything has just gone down the tubes. What do you say to them where we seem like we have a new lease on life? The new page is turned for 2013. We have a clean slate. To wake people up within their downness, if you will, to get up and get moving. I saw a video that you posted this morning via an email that you did. You said, have your inner Madagascar. You just got to move it. I was like, I love it. So I'm waking up because I'm come out of 2012 in that space. And so is my husband. And we were up last night reading the Vuja Day moment together last night, laying in bed at midnight. And we're right getting into that, like, step one. And we couldn't go to sleep. Like, the juices were flowing. Like, what do you say to people that maybe don't have the book yet, that you can just shake them? Is there something that you can say that would just shake somebody out of their dirty, filthy shoes and say, got to put on a new pair?
Well, three things. Number one, failure is not final. Mm. Failure is only feedback. So whatever they have experienced, which is seemingly like failure, loss of job, loss of home, living off of their retirement, living off of their savings, mm-hmm. whatever that might be, mm-hmm. that might appear to be failure. Failure is only feedback, and you got to take it as that and not commit verbal judo on yourself. Mm-hmm. That's number one. Mm-hmm. Number two, in the dictionary, failure comes before success. Mm. So until you have walked through a season of you don't know what you don't know, until you walk through a season of I can't figure it out, I'm stuck in neutral, I see the light is green, but I can't even put my foot mm-hmm. on the right. gas to accelerate, and everybody is zooming by me, what the heck is going on?
Right.
Until you have walked in what many would call the dark night of the soul, you will not have an appreciation for when you are at the top of the mountain. So how you get through this is to believe. In the words of my friend Willie Jolly, a setback is a setup for a comeback.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to have that comeback piece in your heart and in your mind. And then the third thing is, and this is the video that I just put out today and even yesterday, we have entered into what I am declaring and calling the bring it economy, where every single day you've got to bring it, you got to leave it all on the floor, you got to make it happen. Not because you have to, but because you want to.
Mm-hmm.
So for everyone that's listening right now, I want you to find your want to. And when you have that want to, you'll get a chance to.
Mm. Find your want to.
I'm taking notes.
Me too.
I think everybody in the studio is taking notes as you're talking, Simon. know, and you know, coming from you know nonprofit background, and you know, we have a lot of people who, you know, they join a nonprofit not necessarily for the financial gain, but because of the passion. But you know, during these you know kind of trying times for a lot of nonprofits, how do you know if you're listening, and a lot of our listeners are heads of nonprofits or managers of nonprofits, how do you then provide or create an environment so that your employees have like that Vuja Day moment? Like, how do you nurture that within an organization?
Well, first of all, everything rises and falls on the leader. So those that are listening to us right now, I want them to be very mindful of how are they showing up every single day, because people feed off of your energy, and it's the non-verbal communication and the micro messages that people pick up more powerfully than what comes out of your mouth. So spend time before you even go to your place of business. Spend time working on you, meditating in the morning, getting quiet, creating a list of affirmations. And if anybody wants like affirmations or some of the things that we do on meditation, I've got a whole ebook called Meditate on Your Personal Brilliance and Meditate on Your Professional Brilliance. And as a special gift, I'll be happy to give that to anyone who sends us an email at hello@simontbailey.com. I'll make sure that they get that as a gift. But
nice.
Really work on you in the morning, because here's the deal. How you start the day determines the day, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then when you're in the office, really think about spending the time to connect with everyone with hello, good morning. If you have a team that works virtually, send ping them, IM them, whatever you need to do just to create a touch point. And I really learned this the hard way. I got promoted into leadership at Disney. I thought I was hot stuff. And the reality is I was clueless as a leader, but I didn't want you to know that I didn't know what the heck I was doing, so I pretended like I knew.
Mm-hmm.
And the feedback when I met with HR, because they were trying to do an intervention with me, because at best I had a lot of information that was a mile wide but an inch deep. You got it? So they said, Simon, it's all about connecting with people in the morning to ask them how they're doing, how was their day, how was their weekend. And I'm like, really? They should be happy they have a job. They're working at the happiest place in the world. It's like, wah, 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 you know. And they said, dude, that's like your problem right there. And I was like, rut-row. So then,
rut-row.
I thought I was the only one that did that.
I had to adjust my behavior to realize there's one thing to communicate. There's a different thing to connect. So everyone listening, I want you to remember, in the movie Jerry Maguire, Renee Zellweger says to Tom Cruise, you had me at hello.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have your employees at hello? Mm-hmm. And then as you go throughout the day, do you compliment them on what they're doing right, not what they're doing wrong?
Mm-hmm. That's so true. You know, one of my first position as a CEO was for an organization that was struggling financially. And I was new. I was, you know, in my early 30s. I had no idea what I was doing. I'd never been a CEO before. And so I was sort of winging it. And I was so used to, you know, being on my BlackBerry when I walked in the middle of a call or in the middle of returning an email. Like, I just bypassed everybody as I walked from the parking lot to my office. And it's so true. You do set the tone for the organization, because then I noticed no one was talking. No one was saying hello. And then I would, you know, emerge like 15 minutes later and like, oh, hey, how come nobody's talking? How come everybody looks depressed? And fortunately, I had a very good HR person as well. And she's like, do you realize you don't say hello to any of us when you come in?
Uh-oh.
And I was like, I don't. And she's like, yeah, it kind of makes us all feel bad. Like, why are we here? Are we not that important? Like, whatever is going on your phone is more important than who's here helping you. And so that was kind of my shift in how I kind of worked with employees and how I led employees. So it does make a difference. So anyone who's listening right now who is a manager or ahead of a nonprofit, you know, you do set the tone, and if you're going to set the tone, make it a positive one.
Yeah, and now what if, let's switch it. Then what do you say to the employee who's a little guy on the totem pole who has all this excitement and zeal and is emasculated as if they're a man in their position at work because they're never given kudos, they're never mm-hmm. patted on the back, but they have this still this excitement and this want to do things better in their role. What do you say to them where they don't have managers and CEOs and presidents that, it's that trickle-down effect. Mm-hmm. How the leader leads is how the people at the bottom work. But if that's what's happening, if there's corruption, if you will, of a heart or mind from the top, how does someone at the bottom help change that atmosphere without, getting a pink slip?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good point.
Well, one of the things I would recommend is they go to their senior leader and say to him or her, what is it that I can help you to be successful? What is it that I can take off your plate? How can I make you shine? Because sometimes you have to pay it forward and almost do like reverse psychology to really get what you need. And then say to them, what else is it that I could do to help this organization thrive? And it's almost kind of feeling like you're taking one for the team. You're mm-hmm. like, really, dude? Seriously? But what you are doing is it won't change necessarily them, mm-hmm. but it will change how you see them. And when you change how you see them, though your cup is not being filled emotionally or from a recognition standpoint, giving and helping that leader, helping him or her shift their thinking or their focus, I think can go a long way. So that's number one. Number two, now you have some people who are just clueless, who just don't get it. They are emotionally unavailable. And if you're not getting what you need from the workplace because you do spend more time at work than you do at home, then the other question you have to ask yourself, am I in an environment where I am tolerated or where I am celebrated?
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
And then make that determination as to, so what's the next step? And I'm not necessarily saying quit. Is there another division or another department or somewhere else that you can go where you can feel the love?
Absolutely. And I think we're going to take another quick break. So we'll be right back with Heart for the Community and Simon T. Bailey.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With the ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pitbull Energy Drink. Pitbull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With the ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pitbull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
Month passing absence, well, it just seems like forever when I don't see your face. I used to have a clear vision of what I wanted, now every kiss is just now haunted. You've changed, heart's changed, mind changed. Now I'm falling so hard. I'm falling so hard for someone new. Singing the words to my song, they were engraved in your heart. You never said a thing. You never sang along.
Heart for the Community on heartforradio.com. We are broadcasting live from RMC Studios in Los Angeles, California on the Punch It Radio Network, and you just heard live in studio Bernice and her performance of...
That was Never Sing Along.
That was beautiful.
And I didn't this time.
And I won't from here on out, because I made it clear.
That's a lie.
We're all about having fun here. So we are back with Heart for the Community. Want to give again a shout out to our executive producer, Larry Witherspoon, and our lovely sound engineer, Kiki, for keeping us on track and making us sound good. Again, we want to thank our sponsor for today's show, which is the Palmdale Express West Rail Summit, being hosted on January 28, 2013 at the Palmdale Cultural Center from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Admission is free. And if you would like more information, contact Stanley Washington at 702-581-2687. So we are back with Simon T. Bailey talking about the Vuja Day moment. And one of the things that I was flipping through the book during break was you said that we need to commit emotionally. Can you talk a little bit about that?
The Corporate Leadership Council out of D.C. did an interesting study of 50,000 employees in 30 different industries in 10 different countries. And what they say is emotional commitment is more important than rational commitment in driving discretionary effort. So discretionary effort means I'm going to go the extra mile. I'm going to give every bit of myself, not because I have to, but truly because I want to. So that want to, how that connects with emotional commitment, is that's when you make that decision that I am so dialed in and locked into the thing that I am pursuing that I'm not going to quit halfway, but I'm going to stay the course. So, for instance, a person has set maybe a weight loss goal or a goal to go back to school or a goal to just become better at whatever that is. They have to emotionally commit to get up every day and put one foot in front of the other and do it consistently. So I believe emotional commitment, when you really tap into it, all of a sudden the universe begins to bring people into your quantum field, into your matrix, who have been called to aid and help you, all because you emotionally committed to the moment. And when you emotionally commit, I believe you also mature and stop pushing water uphill, mm-hmm. but you really get into the flow. Because you're like, I'm in it. I am all in. I'm in it to win it. But I'm not. So let me say it a different way. Another way to think about emotional commitment is having detached intention. And detached intention says my attention is in the moment. I'm focused. I'm thinking about the choices, the people I'm surrounding myself. But my intention is for the outcome of the thing I've emotionally committed to. So I release the need to become a control freak mm-hmm. and to try to figure out how it's going to happen or when it's going to happen. I'm just going to show up every single day and do the very best that I can and leave the rest to the universe.
Mm-hmm. You know, and we've had, other... speakers on the show, and I'm noticing kind of a theme about what you throw out into the universe. The universe really wants to be able to give that to you, and so if you're gonna throw out positive energy and positive vibes, it's gonna come back to you. It's kind of that law of attraction.
Mm-hmm. For sure, and it's thinking about. Not only what are you throwing out, but are you being consistent in your follow-through?
Mm-hmm. Because that's true. I've had conversations with people where they sort of talk about, I'm going to throw this out into the universe and wait for it to come. Mm-hmm. That doesn't always happen.
Yeah. Yeah, and sitting and waiting for something. God, how many times have I done that? Mm-hmm. How many times in people in general do we do that? So then the New Year's comes, and what does everybody do? Get a gym membership.
Mm-hmm.
And they show up that first week, and they don't get the results they want.
Right.
or they're too sore, or someone makes a nice chocolate cake. Or am I just talking about myself? But then that gym membership goes down the tubes, and then that's the last time they're in the gym. And it can be for anything. You can make that be at any situation, whether it be on a work level, on a corporate level, on a business, on a home level, as a mom, as a student. Mm-hmm. And that's what I think I love so much about the Vujade moment is it can, as my husband and I were reading it last night, I was like, I could flip any of this. I can flip it towards, you know, the next book of Rachel and the Lion. I could flip it to, you know, the work that I'm doing now. I can flip it to supporting you on this project and this community. I can flip it on being the best mom I can, being the best wife, keeping the house clean. Like, there's just so many things that it can be. You can adapt the book to any situation, any belief, any culture. So, you know, Simon, first and foremost, bravo, because it's it speaks to everybody. I don't know, you know, after now completing reading it last night with my husband and staying up because we're so addicted to it. No one can read this book and say this is not for me. So you were very much in your Vujade.
You know, and I think also it's important to talk about, you know, setting reasonable goals too. You know, sometimes I know that I've done this, you know, especially when it came to weight loss. Like, I want to be, you know, X amount of pounds. I want to lose 50 pounds, 60 pounds. And then I was one of those people who had the gym membership, and I'm like, okay, I'm a diehard the first, like, 2 weeks. And then by the third week, I'm like, oh, someone will call and say, do you want to have coffee? Okay. I'll go to the gym later. Yeah. So, you know, I think setting up small milestones and then being able to celebrate each of those small milestones as you lead to that bigger sort of goal or vision.
Wow. That's awesome.
Because even with Heart4, I think it's the same way. Like, I have very big goals on where I would like it to go. But then, you know, when you get to the day-to-day, you're kind of like, is this the right decision? Did I make the right decision? And, you know, leaving kind of a 9-to-5 job to pursue what my passion is. Is this my passion? You have all these questions. So I guess maybe for someone like me, Simon, who really believes in the passion, but then has these moments of like, I don't know if this was right. What would your suggestion be?
Repeat, say it again. Say it one more time.
You know, for someone like me who, you know, I left, you know, kind of a 9-to-5 job, you know, nonprofit to pursue my passion, which is Heart4, and all the things that we're trying to do within the community. And then you have these moments where you start to question, like, gosh, did I make the right choice? Is this having an impact? Do other people see what I see? Am I just crazy? you know, how do you sort of deal with those little obstacles or barriers or doubts?
So I call those the gremlins of brilliance, the gremlins that sit on your shoulder to zap your energy and to question everything that you're doing. And what happens when you're blazing a trail that perhaps few have ventured into, you have to find a way to love and be grateful for where you are and the difference you're making. So I'll give you an example. Over the holidays, I was really challenged with, you know, looking at the last 10 years, have I made a difference, have I added value, and not necessarily beating myself up, but to your point, really questioning everything. And so I realized that I had a little folder that I had been saving different emails that I received from people over 18 to 24 months, and of people who've read my books or have seen me somewhere speak or have watched me on YouTube or whatever. And I decided to read through those, and I start cutting and pasting them and putting them in a separate Word document. And turns out I had over like 100 pages of people that have emailed me that I never stopped to really see what they were saying other than, hey, I respond, thanks, great. But I really took time. And all of a sudden, I said, doggone it, it's totally worth it. I mean, look at this value. Mm-hmm. So what I would say, find those that love what you're doing and have gratitude. They may be few, but their words are so powerful. And your goal is the quality of the conversation, not the quantity of conversations. You know, and how can you extract the quality that continues to push you to say, you know what, I am making a difference. I am adding value. Because sometimes we all just need to have a hug with words. We just need to be hugged by words, you know.
Very true.
And in your book, you do talk about those seasons that you even had, you know, when you left Disney and you were like, wait, what? What did I do? And then having opportunities that come and you say, should I take those opportunities or should I go with where my gut is calling me to? And to have that that sense of conviction that is so strong that you say, I have to, because then I will live in a world of what ifs. But you even said it very plainly in the book. You just got to get past those. Like, how many times did you have to encourage yourself to get to that next level, you know, and often. To shut off those demons, you know, in your head?
Gremlins.
Yeah.
I still do it today.
That's awesome.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
Well, one of, we have Kimberly who's listening, and she was on our show right before the holidays. And one of her recommendations that I'm still holding with me is having accountability partners.
Yeah.
And so creating my goals for 2013, I emailed them out to a few people, like, okay, this is what I'm trying to do. Hold me to them. Like, I'm not expecting you to do them for me, but really, like, ask me, like, how's it going, you know, so that I'm... It's a reminder, and I'm constantly aware of this is what I'm trying to move towards. Because in 2012 was the first time I created goals for myself, ever.
Wow, really?
I've always created goals for the organizations that I worked for, but never for myself as a person. Okay. And so I created them, and then I just sort of put them away, and then I never looked at them. But as I started to go back and look at it, I realized, especially... You know, I've always struggled with my weight. So the weight one was kind of the one I was really focused on. And as I looked at it, I realized that even without intention, I was slowly accomplishing that goal because I had put that out in the universe as something I wanted to do.
Wow.
And then when I created my goal for 2013, I had a photo of me in 2010. The photo of me from last year, and then sort of my ideal photo that I photoshopped my face onto. And I was actually really surprised that I could see now this sort of transition in myself. So I'm like, oh, man. So if I did something with, you know, more, a little more intention, what could I really do?
Wow. That's amazing.
So, I mean, and I guess for me, that was sort of my Vuja Day moment, like really changing and how I thought about the situation, you know, my current situation, but looking at it from a different perspective.
Absolutely.
I kind of want to turn and maybe ask Bernice or Kiki, like, if they have questions and want to participate in the call, like, you know, because I know Kiki always writes notes and she always learns something, and because she's running the soundboard, she doesn't always participate. So, oh, she has a lot of questions.
Notes.
So I'm going to just kind of turn it over to Kiki or Bernice first and have you ask Simon a question, a general question, or maybe something specifically for you?
Let me see. You can go first, Kiki.
You gotta think.
Well, he answered a lot of my questions from the questions that you've asked so far, but he seems very inspiring, and I want to get the book.
Well, he's offering the as a gift an ebook. So if you email hello@simontbailey.com, he'll send it to you.
Yes.
So there
I'm
you go.
I'm going to get it.
Yep, so you can get the ebook, and they can go to Amazon.com and get the Vuja Day moment.
Nice.
Thank you. That's right.
Hi, Simon. Sorry about that. I'm trying to work the cameras. Get me on. Get my audio right. So I'm doing a little bit of everything. I guess my question, it comes back into where I have to say the one thing that really stuck out to me was the greatest tragedy in life is not death, but not knowing the purpose of your life or while you're alive, for that matter. Mm-hmm. My question is when you've got yourself so divided in so many things, but you don't see yourself dropping any of those things. You find value in everything that you're doing. How do you either manage that or actually decide to shut it down? Like, what, like, find the value in what is it? I don't know what the question. I think I've lost my question.
No. I follow you. I totally follow you. And so what you're articulating is sometimes you can have a varied interest in a number of different areas, and you can be really passionate about those areas. How am I doing so far?
Perfect. Right.
That's how good he is.
So how do you really kind of streamline that and become laser focused instead of a floor lamp of diffused energy, right?
Right.
So one of the things you really have to step back and really think about this. When I give myself permission to explore all of the varied interests, I know that I should probably lock in on one, mm-hmm. but could it be that all of those experiences are bringing you to the point of making you what you're supposed to become down the road? So I'll give you an example. Over the holidays, I went through the last 10 years of my business. I've got like 20 pages of flip chart paper all over my office, just trying to understand like what happened. And what I realized, I went down a lot of paths. I went down a lot of roads. I tried a lot of different things, and some failed, and some succeeded, and some failed really bad, and some succeeded extremely well. And what I did is I released the need to judge how the last 10 years happened, and I said, okay, now what am I going to lock in and load on and go deeper in? And so I came to that point. I'm like, okay, it's going to be this. So now I've become very laser-focused on I'm going to do this. But you know what? If I never did all of the other things the last 10 years, I wouldn't be able to take this step now and say, I'm going to do A. Because mm-hmm. I've tried B, C, D, and they were okay, but they don't make my heart sing. They don't make my hair blow in the wind. What little hair that I have, but you get the point.
Right.
So be open to everything and not judge it. Say, what am I supposed to learn? What relationships am I supposed to establish? Because people come in your life and people that come through your life, and it's understanding people that come through your life, they come for a season and for a reason. Mm-hmm. And then you bless them and release them to their brilliant destiny as they yes. move on. But then there are people that come in your life, and that's when you have to really distinguish and discern between a relationship and a transaction. Mm-hmm. What is this really about? What am I really supposed to gain and learn from this? But not just in a spirit of taking, but what am I supposed to be giving as well?
Right.
That's good stuff.
That is very good stuff. I know that we need to take another break, so we will be right back with Heart for the Community on heartforradio.com. We'll be right back.
Hey, are you tired of those same old energy drinks with bad taste? Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pit Bull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products with a guaranteed no aftertaste. Make a switch to Pit Bull Energy Drink. Pit Bull offers more energy with ginseng and vitamins B6 and B12. With a ginger ale lemon lime flavor, Pitbull meets the consumer's demand for better tasting and healthier energy products. For more information on Pitbull energy drinks, bars, and mixes, visit their website at hiphopbev.com. That's hiphopbev.com. Online orders available at hiphopbev.com.
Was it real or was it fake? Was it all a mistake? Will it ever be the same? Will it ever be the same? Was my mind just playing games? Boy, I just gotta know, was it all in my head? Could you tell me, was it real or was it all in my head?
Thank you, Bernice. I'm so glad that you're here.
Thank you. I didn't know where to stop on that song.
I think you could have kept playing and we would all have been happy with that.
Thank you.
So let me give you an opportunity to talk a little bit about yourself and how people can, you know, book you or get a hold of you and listen to your music.
Well, I'm from Fontana, California, singer-songwriter. You can find my music at BerniceRivellis.com or YouTube and Twitter and everything right there. All of the links are on my
page. Spell your last name again.
R-E-V-E-L-E-S.
Awesome.
Oh, there's my card.
There's my card. And I know she didn't want us to, but when you do call and you book Bernice, you'll actually be speaking to Bernice's mother, Isabel, and she's here today as well. So I know that we're going to be starting to wrap up the first hour, and then we're going to go actually into a Google Hangout for about 30 minutes. So this is our first time in actually having a Hangout with our speaker in the Hangout. So thank you so much, Simon, for joining us in the Hangout later.
Thank you. It's going to be fun. I look forward to it.
And I just got your tweet. I'm having a blast, too. I wondered if you could take a moment, and because I know I struggle with this a lot, between, targeting my energy to something, you know, that I'm supposed to be and just sort of wasting, like wasted energy. I saw that in the Vujia Day moment, and maybe you could kind of talk about that and give us strategies on how we can identify it and then transition from it.
Great. So number one, at the beginning of a new year, many people set goals. And there's nothing wrong with setting goals and wanting to achieve something. However, where a lot of people get tripped up and where a lot of people in my field of expertise never really close that loop is you have to change your habits, because the secret of your future and really having and experiencing what I call the Vujia Day moment is hidden in your daily routine. So how do I become very mindful of how I show up and what I'm doing specifically? So let me give you an example. A teacher was working with a student, and he said to the student, "I want you to take this bow and arrow, and I want you to shoot it through the eye of the wooden bird." And so he had two students. And so the guy said, "Okay, great." And so he takes one of the students and he said, "Are you ready?" He says, "Yeah, I'm ready to shoot the arrow." And he says, "So what do you see?" He says, "Well, I see the sun, I see the trees, I hear the wind, and I see the eye of the bird." And he says, "I want you to wait right here." And then he said to the other student, he said, "What do you see?" He says, "I see the eye of the bird." And he says, "Go ahead and release your arrow." And sure enough, it went through the eye of the wooden bird. And the whole point is, until you focus, you'll be scattered. So how you get focused is specifically think about, if there are 24 hours in a day, how do I carve out 15 minutes a day? If you're a morning person in the morning, If you're an evening person, night owl, 15 minutes before your head hits the pillow. And take that 5 minutes. Take 5 minutes to meditate. Think about if it's in the morning, what am I going to do today? How am I going to add value? Take the second 5 minutes to read something that inspires you. And then take the third 5 minutes to write in your journal and say, I commit to this. I will do this. I am this. And the reason those things are so powerful is because it really helps you get centered internally, right? If you're an evening person, 5 minutes to do the same thing, that meditate. What did I learn today? How did I grow today? That second 5 minutes to read something that inspires you. If you went to dictionary.com, the word inspired means to breathe life into. And then take that last 5 minutes and say, so what is it that I intend to pursue the next day? And as you enter into the night season, all of a sudden, intuitively, your inner being begins to find avenues to bring to pass that thing that you're believing for. But it starts with, how do I manage my time? But even more importantly, how do I deploy my energy into the time I have?
Very good point.
Very inspirational.
Mm-hmm. And Kiki passed me a note to say thank you.
And from me.
Oh, it's from Bernice. For both, okay.
I'm definitely buying your book. Or getting it.
Well, you know, I know that we're wrapping up, and so I want to maybe turn it over to you again, Simon, and have you, you know, give people your website and how they can get a hold of you. If they would like for you to come speak at their event, how would they do that? And then maybe sort of the top three strategies or tips that you want our listeners to walk away with today for this hour.
Well, first of all, thank you again for this opportunity. Love your work. Congratulations to you on a brilliant year.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, people can go to SimonTBailey.com, and they can sign up for our newsletter. They can follow me on Twitter at Simon T. Bailey, Facebook, Simon T. Bailey. And on the Simon T. Bailey, it's probably best for them to access my Facebook page from my website, because that's the public figure page and my fan page. And then obviously LinkedIn, and we've got a number of videos on YouTube and Vimeo where they can find us. And if there's anyone that wanted to really ask a question but they didn't want to email it in or ask over the air, they can just send me an email at hello@simontbailey.com, and I'll be happy to answer their question there as well. And I, the three things that I really want people to think about is, how do I show up, how do I step up, and how do I never, ever again back down? And what I mean, show up, when you think about who you are and where you are, a title on a business card, you're bigger than that. So when you think about showing up, how do you bring you? Because people buy you first, and then whatever else you're marketing.
Right.
So it's all about know, like, and trust, right?
Right.
And then step up. When you think about Five Guys Burgers and Fries, they give you a little something extra for nothing. You get these extra fries. You're like, oh, my God, it's, like, phenomenal. You know, and obviously the West Coast equivalent is In-N-Out Burger. Mm-hmm. How can you give a little something extra? And then never, ever back down, because this is your life. You live it, and no one else can live it for you.
Amen. Absolutely. Thank you so much. And Stephanie?
Can you let the listeners know that want to see us live on the next hour how to do that so that they know?
Well, this is our first time doing a Hangout, so I would think that once we start the Hangout, I'll be able to post the link from YouTube and on our Facebook page, and I'll tweet it out, and then I can connect them to your page as well.
Okay, and then
they just click on the link, and then they can watch that way. If you would like to participate in the Hangout with us, then you need to email or message me on Facebook or Stephanie, and we can try to link you in that way.
Great. Good. So we have a second hour, so if you want to even get even more, you got to keep going. And Simon, you said that you were going to be on for the first 30 minutes, correct? Yeah. Uh-huh. So if anybody wants to get any more, they got 30 more minutes. So, and we'll start that in just a little bit.
Absolutely. So thank you, everyone, for listening to Heart for the Community. Have an amazing 2013. Everyone, Bernice, thank you for being
thank
here
you
today.
Thank you for having me. Thank you.
You're welcome. Please come back.
I will.
And remember, everyone, you can change the world one heart at a time. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Say that you need me, so I haven't you made your move. 'Cause I have counted all those times you stared at me with those brown eyes, and you just sit there like a cute little fool. So come on, next to me, together we can be.